Yeah, and welcome back to Thoracic Art. Oh, right. I've got a couple of plans in the work. First, I'm going to have a go at it's going to be I am going to do my tilted ring, my tilted open gold. Which means I just need to grab. Tough enough, that's not the one I wanted. I wanted the long one. Most of the time, these don't come individually wrapped, these canvases. But unfortunately, this time I have, which is kind of annoying because I don't like all of the waste plastic, but I don't really have a choice. So, as people have, those of you who watched me before will know, my tilted open cork actually involves, instead of doing the colours individually, I make a cork, then I put my ring, put my base coat on, put my ring on my canvas, tilted, pour the whole cork in, and then lightly drop it down. This one is Fluorescent Sour Lemon by Arteza, and it is in the Harmony Tones set by Arteza. It's a very, very bright, vibrant yellow. Azo Orange by Amsterdam. This is Deco Art Bronze with a bit of red mixed in. in love. It's a beautiful, rich colour. It's mostly copper with a little bit of red in it. This one is primary yellow by Amsterdam. I know I might have mixed a little bit of white in this, but it really isn't. If there is white in it, it's only a teeny tiny amount. I really like that yellow because it's a really, what I call a sunshine yellow. It's a really warm, vibrant yellow, whereas the fluorescent yellow is, it's got an almost slightly green cast to it. And this is the Deco Art Ruby with a healthy, squidge of the primary magenta by Amsterdam in it. And you know everyone knows this one, this is 24 karat gold by Deco Art. And this is a little bit thicker, just because I actually want to see the gold. I don't want it to, because it does tend to disappear and form a sheen. If you don't leave it a little bit thicker than the other paints. It's still a beautiful, beautiful colour. Another squidge of white in there, just to create a little bit of separation. Give it something for the fluorescence to stand out against. They want nice thick layers now. I did thin the layers at the bottom, mostly because I tend to wrinkle the last little bit of the cup into the open cup, just so that if I get a pattern left in the centre, because it's a very wide open cup, I usually tend to tilt it off. But it's always handy that if you are going to keep it, it's worth making sure that you can do something a little bit pretty with it. to map to the primary yellow. I do like the like the contrast between the primary yellow, which is like very warm and very sunny, and the fluorescence of the sour yellow of the Arteta one. I do think it's a nice contrast having both yellows in the pot. Thank you. don't normally do this because I tend to create a muddy thing, but I do like kind of doing a bit of a weird everything that was in that course, which is now in this circle. Now this is literally, I don't want it to go too far, just one of that. Developing, this is a very fantastic technique. There is no silicone in any of my paint, mostly because I'm too lazy to clean it off, because it's a load of extra effort. And I love the art, I don't love the cleaning. Back into the center.
super sarcastic son.
Why? Why? Should I even call it that? Gonna rerun over with the torch. I don't think we can get any more cells, but this is stunning. Collection of cells in there. Absolutely beautiful. Bring it back. Hopefully you can get hopefully a proper view of the whole thing. Minus my god awful camera wiggle. Okay, thanks very much, and I shall be seeing you soon. Take care of yourselves, and look after each other. All the best.